Earthshaker just waves her arms around helplessly.
He can at least echo.
That's true.
Yeah.
But that is normally you don't want to be echoing the clock.
Nope. Especially in an isolated environment.
Well, they've got 5 seconds here. Time is up. What's it going to be?
Two? What? Ooh, it's an Enigma.
Ice Enigma offlane, it looks like.
Yeah, offlane Enigma. They have a lot of huge teamfight control. And offlane Enigma is also... You can actually pull the wave back, so you get some decent deny on Queen of Pain's levels, and you get a lot of farm compared to a normal offlaner.
But it is against the Kuroki Rubick, yes. And he has been styling on people lately.
This Rubick is going to be so happy this game. Fissure and Black Hole.
Uh-huh. Easy Shrapnel Steel, too.
Easy Shrapnel Steel.
Yeah, you get the 3 charges no matter what.
Yeah.
Can steal it again.
Wow, this looks like a big Rubick game. The more
it really does. Fissure, Ice Blast, Black Hole... Assassinate.
I think they're gonna have a lot of problems protecting Black this game. Like, he has to deal with like a Chen army, a Queen of Pain blink, and Clockwork. Like, all these are gonna be like very problematic for him.
If he gets caught by Hookshot, there's really nothing. Like, Fissure won't help you there. Maybe they have to find a way to rush a four staff for someone. But even then, there's so much damage.
Get the four staff himself, perhaps.
Enigma four staff instead of blink, maybe. Anyways, the game is about to start. Ben, thank you for joining us.
What are your expectations for this game?
I like Secret's lineup a little bit more. I think they have a better combination of like AoE damage, late game, and laning. Vici's lanes, I'd say, are a little weak. The sniper is fairly weak. They're all very weak to ganking. Ancient Apparition and Earthshaker, you know, they're fairly weak early, and they had to play reactively as opposed to offensively, and I don't think that Secret will feel that much pressure.
Okay, so your money's on Secret then?
Yes.
Bruno, are you sticking with the house here?
I'm sticking with this house pick. It's Secret all the way through, and we'll see what happens after this engagement. For now, LD Winter, take us away.
All right, Vici Gaming getting aggressive here. They want to slow down that Chen early on and try to get some wards up, perhaps, but for now, they back off as a pack of five. They're going to plop down an observer when I think Secret spotted this. It may be a dewarded very early on. Yeah, Puppy already into position. This is really going to hurt Vici Gaming, I feel. I'm surprised they went for that ward.
Yeah, they could see them across the... I guess it's just like one of those things. You want to do it very quickly, and they were slow, and they got spotted out. So they wouldn't have vision on the bottom rune. Now, it's gonna not be easy for the Enigma. He's gonna run back and just deny a creep from far, starting with 4 Clarity Potions.
This will come in not handy. Gonna deny that. Of course, this is not your jungle Enigma, so he'll just be trying to keep his own lane back. It means that the Shadow Fiend will have a bit of an easier time mid than if it were a jungler. And I think to go back to what Merlini said, Sniper, Enigma, these are very easily ganked heroes, so... With the Rubick Chen, if they want to go for some wraparound plays, like between that 3 to 5 minute mark, something Vici Gaming will have to be very cognizant of, but with no wards in the enemy jungle, it's just a guessing game. You're not going to have any intelligence. Maybe you scout with the Eidolons a bit.
Mm-hmm. The good news for them is they managed to get a sentry down at the very least, so Rubick won't have a good time getting levels in the early phase of the game.
Do they have sentry gold on the Enigma? On the Chen?
Chen has one remaining.
Okay. But this is not the easiest camp to deal with.
Not an easy one. He probably won't be able to actually take out that ward. And look at the top lane, Super gonna be the safe lane hero here with the axe, so he's gonna have a lot of weight on his shoulders here when he gets that early blink.
It feels like everything for Vici Gaming in the mid game will revolve around the axe.
Yeah, every time you pick the axe and you put a hero like axe on a safe lane, he's gonna have very huge shoulders to feel.
Puppy just being a nuisance here mid. Black 5-0 for now, but Arteezy getting his farm. This is just classic Secret with the Chen, pressuring the mid lane early, keeping the sniper distracted, and trying to give Arteezy the easiest possible time. Speaking of which, we can see the Chen already stacking the big camp, it looks like, off in the Radiant Jungle, and yeah, he'll be... that gets the medium camp for now, and just looks like they'll be looking to accelerate Arteezy's farm. I wonder if we'll see Puppy take the creeps for himself, or if they leave it for Arteezy this time around. It's a decision he'll make later on. But one that has big implications for their overall strategy.
But for now, the offlane for VG, as expected, going a little bit better than the offlane of Secret because Enigma is able just to deny. And you could see the last hits of the Quap is suffering because of that. Has 6 last hits to the 9 of the Axe at this point. And Clockwork has a little less farm than the Enigma as well.
So early on Winter, do you look at the offlane, it slightly favors Vici Gaming, but do you think that makes up for this jungle Chen? Who do you favor here so far?
Definitely, you have a jungle Chen, you're going to have the economical battle on your hands when the Chen takes out the stack just like that. You were talking about how he was stealing the Shadowfiend stack the other game, but I think if you can get an early mech and change the tide of battle, it's always worth it.
Against Vici Gaming, mech is not guaranteed to be a game changer, though. That's where the Ice Blast can be the X factor.
Yeah, it depends how early you get and whether the AA is level 6. If you actually win a fight early before the Ice Blast comes online, it's going to be worth it.
For now, Kuroki's Rubick. It looks like he did manage to deward that camp, or either that or the sentry expired. But either way, Eidolon's proving to be a nuisance.
Yeah, just look at the Enigma at this point. He got quite a number of last hits and denies already.
Ice is just, it reminds me a lot of, you know, like the Bulldog Nature's Prophet as well in the offlane. Just, he's very good at slowing down enemy supports and wasting their time. You even go back to his lone Druid back when this hero, we're gonna have a rotation on mid. Fissure to start. FY looking to set up an Arteezy who drops one raise. You gotta stay close. Prevent him from getting off either of those long range raises. If he turns, this could go poorly. FY, oh no, he's walked up the cliff. He's gonna go down. The Chen army arrives and Black unable to finish the job.
I actually think they probably get the kill if he has
another point in shrapnel.
Yeah, he had 1-1-2 just now. Another point in the game.
That was just, it's one of those situations as Earthshaker, you can't back. Because if you back, then he just turns and raises you and you die.
Yeah, he gets you with the longest raise and you're still going to be dead anyway. He has to go in for the kill.
So close. That's a heartbreaker for Vici Gaming. Yeah. Now, Arteezy going to be snowballing. He got sent back, I think, by the Chen. And so, hardly any time at all is wasted.
Yeah, that was just, he just received so much support all the time in all the games from Puppy.
It's always 2v1 mid. And Earthshaker mid, like, until they go for the Fissure block, just isn't doing as much as the Sniper. Or as the Chen, rather.
And here comes Zai with a double damage, looking to find a pickoff here. With 2 points in clock, win the battery assault.
Zai swinging around. He has some kill potential if he catches out the support mage version. And meanwhile, bottom lane, there's a jump in. It looks like they want to go on the Enigma. Ice taking damage, but it's a little dangerous to dive him with the Eidolon starting to lay into Kuroki. Now they will despawn. And Secret continue to apply pressure. Ice has to stay back. He needs FY to rotate in. He's a bit low to get into the lane. He'll bring in the Eidolons, looking to micro them as well as possible. I guess the key thing for Secret so far, Zai not dying in the offlane, he is getting his levels. Everything pretty much going according to plan thus far. Nobody is falling too far.
They're gonna bait. He's gonna blink it.
Well, not much of a bait when they lose Ice off the bat. S4, just swinging through the trees. FY with the fissure, not sufficient. Now a rocket coming in. Secret, S4, about to blink out, but can't get it in time. 2 seconds to go. Nice body blocking there by Ice with those tiny little conversions.
They almost expire as well. He just barely had enough time to actually block him and get the kill.
Still getting the experience and the gold on that Enigma kill. Earthshaker not really the hero that uses it the best this early. I think Secret are fine with that.
FI top lane, Zai. He's gonna get stuck here on the other side and he's gonna go in on Super here. Rubick is gonna come in as well.
Super not getting many spins. In fact, Kuroki will arrive. Now they try to jump on him. They have a Cooling Blade. They get the call. Now he's out of mana. Needs more spins. He'll get quite a few. Now Zai in trouble. Will the RNG be with Super? He gets the spin. They get the double kill. It's a huge one. Fenrir getting both of those. You'd probably rather if Super did, but two kills, they'll take them. Much needed. Vici Gaming, we're starting to slip a bit behind in this laning stage.
Yeah,
that brings them right back.
He would have almost have his blink if he got the kill. It's still fine for them. AA got the much needed level. He's going to have his Midas if he wants to. He's going to have halfway along the journey cut already with the two kills he has there.
Nice. Looks like he's working towards the Sol Ring, I believe, now in the offlane. And he is getting his levels. Level 5, about to hit 6 early on. Trying to trade blows here with S4. He might build a black hole him under tower if he cracks 6, but
still needs one.
Just needs that one more creep.
One more creep, yeah. Before he has.
Or maybe two. Yeah, there's your level 6. So, how's Super doing towards his blink? He's got 34 CS, 1600 gold. If he had those kills, he would already have the blink. But it will still be a pretty fast one.
Yeah, he's still gonna get it fairly soon, and looking at the middle lane for Black, he's starting to fall behind against the Shadow Fiend as expected. With a sniper, when the Shadow Fiend gets levels with Necromastery and the race, you're just gonna fall behind. And he even got a kill on F5 before that with the first blood.
It's just gonna be about the X-Blink. Once he gets it, is this gonna go the way of the game we saw yesterday from IG, where I think it was IG, right?
Yeah, it was IG.
Versus Na'Vi, where they get three kills, they steal a bunch of stacks and just take over the game, or will it be one of those games where Secret are ready, they have the Chen in position, they get a send back off, Rubick lift interrupts the gank, and things just go south. It's just gonna be, it's gonna come down to who gets the better reaction to the jump.
Yeah, he's very close to it, and looking at the other lane still, Secret gonna continuously pressure the bottom tower. Enigma got a lot of farm and a lot of denies on the Quap, so Quap's not gonna have a very, very smooth game here. Not too many CS at 8 minutes, 36, as a result of that.
It's hard to shut them all down, though. If you have to really see any game where Secret loses all the lanes convincingly. Maybe they did in that Hellraisers game, I was not casting it, but it sounds like that was the closest they came to losing
all
the lanes.
Yeah, heroes are just not meant to lose the lanes, though, with the Chen assisting the Shadow Fiend.
Oh, this could be big, but do they want to go on Arteezy? I don't know if they can jump him. They're really going to need a plus one. The axe off in the woods. Looks like he's trying to finish up the stack here, or maybe not even stack, just a single big camp. But yeah, it is a stack. Big Bird not cooperating. He buys the blink.
He's going to have to blink right now.
Arteezy already farming ancients. He just doesn't really want to be in the lane right now. The wave gets pushed into the Dire Tower, and just better to be invisible. Don't be a target with
Once they show on the map, Zai will feel confident to get his solo kill on the AA. He's level 7 and he just needs intel on where the Earthshaker is, where the axe is, and he can go for the kill.
Yeah, they have that one lane ward mid. They might see the Earthshaker if he pokes his head down, but he's still up the ramp in the Dire Jungle. And he's gonna go for the hookshot. He says, screw it, on to Fenrir, level 6 now. He chucks out the Ice Blast, it will connect on Zai. They need a little more from Super. Gets off the Battle Hunger, and it looks like Zai probably goes down. There's your chop. Gets the counter kill. A good trade for Vici Gaming, getting the core just for a support Ancient Apparition. And it's already after the AA level 6 comes out.
Yeah, but at the very least, Secret now, they know the Axe teleported top. The other lanes would feel a lot comfortable.
And they know he has the Blink, that's the other thing.
Chen creep's gonna get blocked by the Fiend.
Can he just test the faith them back here? Yeah, he's gonna try, but
he's gonna lose the wolf. Actually, he didn't even lose the wolf. I thought he's gonna lose the wolf.
Yeah, man, this is the important one though. Arteezy trapped out, dunked by Super. This is the kind of hot start you need from that axe, and with that, it brings Arteezy well within striking distance. Well, we were talking about the importance of the Blink Winter, and they're off to a very good start with it.
Yeah, two kills so far off the bat after he got the blink, and he's gonna go back to base, has 800 gold to spend, has a smoke as well. The next key kill, obviously if he gets another kill when the Shadow Fiend comes back to middle, would be great. But getting a kill on the Clockwork or the Queen of Pain here wouldn't be too bad either for the Axe. He's gonna TP
Kuroki, jumping onto Ice bottom, he will get caught out with Zai together. They set up, they take down that Enigma. Ice Blast coming in, and they get the jump. The call's there as well. They've stolen it. Are they gonna try to call back the other way? Kuroki walking in like he wants to. That's a manly little Rubick. But he'll back on out.
Probably not a good idea with Earthshaker coming in.
Hey, how you doing? Plus, the Axe is the one who's gonna have the chance to spin. Not the other way around.
Well, Enigma so far still has his black hole. He actually finishes his power chest. Here comes Super again. Call on S4. S4 gets healed up. Couldn't be Culling Blade there by the axe.
But I believe only a level 1 Battle Hunger. Not nearly enough to kill him off.
Yeah.
Steals Fissure for Kuroki.
Wow, that's a big steal there.
Well, we mentioned it's a big Rubick game. And this could be just the beginning. No black hole is even used yet. Assassinate. They're going down on Super. They try to initiate, but he's going to counter this one with a call. A quick dunk. Who do you think you're jumping on, S4?
No, he was late in actually unloading the Sonic Wave, though. Oh my god.
It has that bit of a wind up as well.
They probably had enough time to actually kill there if he actually used. Probably Sonic Wave, then Blink In and Fan. Instead of Blink In and Fan Sonic Wave, they would have been less reaction time for the Earthshaker there. But they're not going to get the kill. And S4, he still hasn't have anything big yet on his item progression, maybe just a quarter stuff, and not even Oblivion stuff.
They get a Sniper Mask of Madness. And if you're Vici Gaming, you just...
Top lane.
They're jumping in on Arteezy.
He's going to black hole.
Going to clear out the trees. Arteezy, does he have any way out of here? He's going to try to walk in. He's channeling a Requiem. Malphus will cancel that. Surrounded and getting just destroyed by Black. We'll pop like a pinata. Easy takedown. Zai on the move, trying to counter this. He's has the smoke. Hookshot coming in, but he misses the hook.
That's too far.
Black with the stutter step. Now super mid, jumping onto S4, who blinks out the Chen creep, preventing FY from going in. Puppy trying to find a solo kill. Does that super have mana? I think he went for the dunk a bit prematurely, and super will end up falling. That's a killing spree ended. Now they lift the Enigma, tossing him back. He has Black Hole. They gotta be careful that they don't end up not having any spells to cancel this. In the end, Secret bouncing off a very intense nail biter of an opening. 7-5 your score. Quad lane mid from both teams right now. Neither team wanting to back off just yet.
Black Hole still not being used like you mentioned, and he's gonna be the one building into the mech for the VG squad. And looking at the Secret side, mech already completed on the Chen a lot faster than the Enigma. But the Black Hole hasn't come into play, so I think when if he gets a blink this game, or probably needs some weakens.
My concern though is for Vici, if they're gonna fall behind. Just Sniper is not a hero that will keep up with a Shadow Fiend. And they have to keep on fighting these kills.
Yeah, the Axe needs to just keep on making space for the team. And
it gets harder now. Shadow Fiend gets a Yules. They got the mech on Chen like 2 minutes ago. Mm-hmm. There's more defensive tools coming out for Secret, and it makes it less likely that Vici Gaming can find these quick assassinations.
They need to find and kill the Shadow Fiend. The Shadow Fiend is so farmed right now. He completes the Yules, has the most last hits in the game, and 6.5k net worth fund. He's gonna be very huge, and Axe needs to... He's trying to build into a early BKB this game. Against all the spell damage that Secret has, but he needs to be... I'm not sure if farming should be his priority right now. He needs to set up kills for VG side. At least make them win a battle so they can actually take down towers or claim objectives.
As for Secret, this is generally how they conduct their mid game. They'll support the Shadow Fiend a lot, S4 and Zai will be mostly left to their own, and then come mid game, they start to spread the map a bit more with the two farming cores, which in this case is the S4 Quap, as well as the SF. Our tracking puppy here in the Radiant Jungle, this could be a quick takedown. Ice Blast is available. Ice is swinging that direction, and Puppy about to get caught out here. As the Malefice comes in, they'll break the tree line. Echo Slam used. Now the Fissure coming through. Ice Blast not going to connect. They even have to commit a Black Hole just to ensure that he doesn't get off that mech Hand of God. And S4 looks to punish this. He turns, but there's backup waiting. Super getting the call. Is he going to get the dunk? He will. Quick Chop secures it. Oh, that looked like it could have gone very poorly for Vici missing the AA ult, but the backup was there. They had the extra plus one at the point of attack, and it ensures that things go all right as Rubick will steal the chop.
Wow, it was close. Puppy was denying the tower with the creep, and Super went in and taunted the creep so they could actually secure the last hit on the tower.
That's a really heads up play by Ice. A lot of players maybe try to save Black Hole, but that could have cost them dearly if they did.
Yeah, if he got off his ultimate, that would probably be a different fight. So it was a well used Black Hole in the end, and it's going to put him much closer to the mech on the Enigma.
You know, that said though, Secret are still just making the best out of any sort of mistakes elsewhere. Like, still Arteezy split pushing top. He took down the tier 1. His farm is still pretty outrageous, sitting at 2k net worth already, 140 CS. He's nearly doubling up the sniper in terms of CS. Some of these jungle creeps, but they look for their jump in top lane. They have a hookshot for Zai. Yule's gonna set this up. They hookshot onto FY. Even better, the hero to focus. He was trying to protect Ice. Now the raises maybe come out. No, Arteezy leads with the Requiem. They get the kill in the Earthshaker, but Super looks to turn this one around. He's out of mana though. They're just gonna have to run Zai down with auto attacks. They'll do it. But there's no more opportunity for further chase.
Probably turn out into an unfavorable trade in the end for them. Clockwork for the Earthshaker.
At the same time, I guess he is... he's not a hero they're really expecting to do that much more later on. Just more of the initiator. It's not the Quap or the SF dying.
Yeah, at least.
I guess the ES for Vici Gaming, FY, he'll need a Blink Dagger at some point this game. He's up to 750 gold.
we talk about the importance of having a 4-star against the Clockwork, but so far, none of their heroes are building 4-star. Blackman for the carry type of build, Mask of Madness, Yasha, a lot of movement speed, but will not be helpful if he's trapped in the power cocks of the of Zai. So,
Who do you think should build? Enigma is a possibility. The Earthshaker probably just has to go Blink. And AA is going Midas into, I imagine, Aghanim Scepter is the build here. So
I think
it leaves Sniper, Enigma, or maybe Axe.
Axe is going BKB though, and Enigma really wants to get his hands on the Blink Dagger this game. He needs a Blink to be able to get a very good Black Hole. He's not going to be able to walk up that easily, and I'm not sure though. 4-star seems to be the more likely choice, I would say, on the AA after the minus.
Okay.
They really need a 4-star. Maybe even the Earthshaker skipping Blink, but I'm not sure that will be the best option.
As we move towards the mid-game winter, it's 18 minutes in terms of net worth, we're sitting at a slight lead for Secret, about 1,500. They've taken down 2 towers to 1, and experience-wise, it's about dead even. So it's a very close game. Who do you favor right now? The rhythm of the game has been fairly slow over the past few minutes. It's mostly been farming.
If it's slow, it's better for the side with the Quad or Shadow Fiend. Farm much faster, and here comes the
hook. Oh no, Black! This team was right there! They smoked past him! They were swaying around for the backstab mid. They go in with the Blink Call, super airballs it. Now Zai had taking Malifaux damage, but not much else. They're all gonna survive, and now if it's Vici Gaming on the run, the Rocket coming in, S4 maybe even looking to slow one more hero down, Kuroki. Unable to get in close. How unfortunate. They Blink Call Arteezy here though. Ice Blast coming in. There's not too much Fog Fissure. Enough. They get the kill. The send back won't be enough to save Arteezy. And now everybody back into the fight. They buy back on Black. He'll commit on Zai. They get 2 kills here. Super retreating out. They'll clear out the Chen creeps. Ice, ice, ice. On the chase, he has a Black Hole. Kuroki's been tracked down with an Assassinate. They'll pew pew him in to submission. Getting the kill there. Do they walk into Roche now? They're all quite low. The mech is coming off cooldown soon. Let's see what they do. Maybe they just push this tier 1 mid.
Yeah, probably pushing the tier 1 mid would be the more safer option. They don't have that much damage on Roshan either, and some of their heroes don't have mana and stuff like that. The tower is full HP, it's gonna take them a while. Glyph is on cooldown for Secret, so they're gonna be able to take this eventually. Clockwork's gonna respawn. He has a hookshot though. Probably they try to defend this with the hookshot.
If they want to do it, it's gotta be real soon. Hadouken at the start. Zai hooking in, and he'll find Black. Remember, he just fought back. If he dies again, this is a disaster for BG Gaming, but he's standing his ground. He will get the kill first. Now on the run, Black so incredibly low. Watch out for the Hadouken. S4 committing to this one. The Black Hole's gonna catch him. Black survives through it all, but the stolen Ice Blast from Kuroki gets the kill in the end. The Rubik, we said it's a big Rubik game winter, and he delivers in spades. My goodness, that was going to be a great escape.
He probably just, I mean, at least helped them kill the sniper, but they still paid a huge price for it. The Corp and the Clockwork going down just to secure that kill. And if Rubik didn't have the Ice Blast, there was no way they were getting that kill.
And good news for Secret, it really is a one carry lineup though. A dieback, unlike say the Quaff or the Shadow Fiend, there's still another hero to carry the team in the late game, but I'm not sure if Vici have that hero.
Top lane, is Arteezy gonna go in and try to use the axe here?
No
level 2 ultimate.
Yeah, it doesn't have the BKB yet, I don't think.
No,
on the axe.
No BKB on axe.
No
yet.
BKB, okay.
He's very close though. Just needs the recipe and has 1k gold right now. FY, 200 gold shot for his blink as well. He's gonna get it after this creep wave.
A tense game. These teams feeling very evenly matched here. Score 15-8, but Secret getting more farm and a bit more in the way of split push going with the Shadow Fiend Quap, whereas Vici finding the pickoffs, neither team really able to secure a Roshan yet though, which just shows how even the game is. Generally when Secret's been playing, they're taking a Rosh by this stage of the game and completely snowballing the map advantage.
AA is going to build into that much needed 4-star they have against the Clockwork though. Before they have that, it's always risky for them to take a fight. Black might just get focused on, like, in all the fights by the Clockwork.
They're hanging back near mid. They have to clear this wave out, but
Ice Blast coming out from Kuro.
They are getting split pushed pretty hard. The Ice Blast comes in. It'll be an annoying one, hitting on 2. And Black is just damn squishy. Even with the SOI complete, he's lost about half his health just to that. Secret have a lot of... with the stolen Ice Blast and Clockwork Rockets, pretty much every hero gets hit by those, they're down to half health. That's a big spell to steal. It might even be the best spell for him to steal this game, even more than like, say, a Fissure, because you combine the Ice Blast with the Queen of Pain ultimate and the Shadow Fiend phrase, and that's enough to kill almost anyone from full health instantly. They'll shatter quickly.
Yeah, and Zai is going to scout them out with the rocket there, so they know what's up. VG's moving all their heroes up to make sure that Black doesn't get caught out here. So the other lanes will be free for Secret to push. They have Kuroki taking farm in the middle lane, and they're just having much better heroes spread out on the map to just get all the resources into their pocket right now for Secret. And VG going to make another smoke. Black is still alone at top. He's going to run back towards the base, but the other heroes are going to try and catch someone going to the roof.
VG Gaming going to clash here at the rune. The Rubick spotted out quick. Blink call. The chop is there, and they are four near the pit. I wonder if they want to walk in.
Yeah, they're going to go for Sniper, even TP to the bottom here. One.
They're not the fastest Roche lineup. They don't have a medallion right now. Sniper is gone for more kind of utility tank type items. Not really much in the way of DPS for the stage of the game. And Artesia split pushing top.
I don't know about tank, you know. Sniper doesn't feel tank yet.
Well, SMY, it's not really a pure damage item. He's not tanky, though, that is true.
Yeah, it's just like he can move around the fight easier.
It's more mobility and a little bit of attack speed as well.
Do they have the four staff completed yet? No, A is still a long way there. He only has the staff of wizardry. They need to find a way to be able to protect the sniper, otherwise Clockwork is just going to focus him in every fight.
Meanwhile, top lane, Shadow Fiend moving into position here. Does he try to go for that Yule's play? No, BKB up on Super now, so no longer a kill possibility for him. As the Clockwork 4 staff is completed. This game just very tense, very even thus far. Every kill, there seems to be a counterplay. Nobody gaining a clear advantage as of yet.
Now, VG is going to get a blink on Ice. I feel the ideal team fight for them is probably the Axe trying, if he can actually catch out, someone can catch out the Rubick, then the Enigma Black Hole will be what it takes to just win the team fight for VG.
They are starting to congregate on this bottom side of the map, sending four heroes deep towards the Radiant Tier 2, now backing off and retreating together. VG Gaming just keeping a lot of bodies near the sniper. They don't want him off on his own, and it is one of the hero's weaknesses. Unlike the Shadow Fiend with the Yules, you're not as quick to split push, and against the Clockwork, it's not that safe to do it.
Yeah, he's very weak in as a hero, but he does deal a lot of damage from a far range. Right?
If they get the big black hole and call, then Sniper's going to wreck face, especially with an Ice Blast.
Yeah, they are.
It's a bit harder to execute, though, in some ways.
Yeah, heroes are just more well-designed in taking teamfights. At the moment, Secret has no intention of taking teamfights. They're just spreading everyone across the map. And here comes F4, going to get an Echo Stem on Puppy, Ice Blast as well. Take out all his creeps, take out the heal.
Too late. Even with the heal coming out, he does blow the Hand of God. A hookshot onto FY. Is there anything to bail him out here? He's going to try to turn with the Enchant Totem. Queen of Pain out over the top, bringing three low. FY not finished yet, but on the run. Fenrir also low. The Yule Scepter deployed by Arteezy to set up the kill, but in comes Super. He gets the call. Where's the backup for Arteezy? He gets dunked. Super starting to get out of control this game. Chop number two missing, but he might just run Zai down anyway with a Battle Hunger. Oh, he whiffed it. Now the black hole on the two. Fissure over the top. Fiji Gaming bringing down a fourth. The lone survivor, a very low HP Clockwork, who ends up dying to Battle Hunger on the retreat out. It's a team wipe for Fiji Gaming. Oh my. They just got picked apart in that fight.
I was surprised that I actually tried to actually reinitiate after Puppy died as well there. They went into a position which was like they couldn't get everyone there at the same time. They were TPing multiple heroes in, but went in very far ahead first, so they couldn't burst the Earthshaker down from the start, even though the enemy team, which is VG, doesn't have any 4 staff. And in the end, they were spread up, and Isotize MVP there, he found a very good black hole on the quad. And the other hero was the Rubick or the Shadow Fiend. He got a two-man black hole.
Yeah, I think it was the Rubick. Because the Chen was already dead, Clockwork was running
away. Shadow Fiend got Cutting Blade by the Axe as well. So this would be the biggest momentum swing that VG has already taken in this fight. Finally, like you mentioned, someone just appears to Roshan with the advantage they gain. There we go. Aegis on the weak sniper, so he doesn't have to worry too much in the upcoming fights. He's going to be protected by the extra life that he's going to have with Aegis.
I feel we can really feel the impact of the Ancient Apparition this game. Like, last game that we saw out of Secret, they were playing against EG, and there were fights, even better initiations from EG. They got like a 3-hero coil, Queen of Pain fan on 3 or 4, then the Sonic Wave on 3 or 4, but then Hand of God comes out, Mech comes out, and everybody at Secret's at full HP. This game, it doesn't matter. Your Chen gets jumped. Even if he gets off the mech hand of God, the Ice Blast is going to kill these heroes anyway. So that wasn't the 3-4-5 hero combination, but it makes Secret less able to disengage and turn the fights.
Yeah, and Arteezy's blink use didn't do anything the whole game. He was just farming. Like, the use was fine, but the blink is still okay, but it just didn't net him any kills. Just allows him to farm around the map, move around the map faster. He needs the BKB desperately, which he has just only obtained against all the spell damage that VG has. But at the same time, there's still going to be the Axe physical damage and obviously Midnight Pulse as well from the Enigma, which also goes through Magic Immunity.
Does the headshot go through Magic Immunity?
Let me see. Should be physical damage. Yeah, it's physical damage.
But it says it does not pierce spell immunity. It says no. Oh, Kuroki getting caught out. Well, not going to matter for him. That actually hurts a lot. He was very close to the BKB.
The damage should go through, but not the effect. Like the.
Okay, so you don't get the attack speed, move speed slow.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, dunk bottom lane. They're just starting to find kills all over the map. S4, Ice Blast gonna connect. Will this be enough to kill him? No, he turns with the Orchid. Hookshot comes in. S4 may end up surviving here. It's gonna be close to shattering, but I don't think he dies. FY didn't quite do the math right there, and a timely rotation from Zai turns it around. Still, Vici Gaming looking for the push here. It's a support for a support around the map, but the tower, tier 2 top under siege at the same time. It is Arteezy split pushing out mid.
Can't really blame him though, it's really hard to get the numbers right there. It was a really clear opportunity that he could get a kill with the Ice Blast. The only thing I could have think he could have done better was just get an Enchant Totem first before he blinked in with the additional damage that he gives you. That's the best thing that I could think of. And here comes Ice with the Blink and Black Hole. Wants to set up a kill for Arteezy here. Blink, Black Hole, and
on
someone
on the mid lane, are they going to find an opening? Nope, he blinks out.
And top lane, they're going to continuously pressure the tier 2 at top. Rocket Flag gonna scout out the three heroes here.
Well, Winter, here's a good thing tool to have against Ice Blast. They have the Golem now.
Yeah.
Even if you can't go mid lane, there's a jump in. Looking to go on the mid lane onto Arteezy, but the Yule Scepter comes out. He's going to turn with the Requiem. He doesn't get it off just quite right. Now the Black Hole, it's quickly canceled though by the silence of S4. Too bad they can't save Arteezy anyway. S4 now on the run. The Shadow Fiend falling in exchange for an Ancient Apparition. So in the end, another death for Arteezy, and the tier 2 top, I believe, was finished off, denied by Puppy's Chen, though.
Oh, that was a very, very risky play there. Expected to be able to get the Requiem off before the Enigma pops the Black Hole. Slightly just mistimed there, and the Queen of Pain backing up wasn't enough to actually prevent him from going down there.
The pressure comes down mid. Black getting very aggressive on the sniper, and I think the team saying just relax a little bit. Wait for us to
finish his BKB as well. He has his reasoning.
He's quite strong right now with BKB. They have very little physical damage aside from the Shadow Fiend, and the Shadow Fiend has trouble staying in the fights.
Black Hole is on cooldown though. That's like good news for Secret. If VG decides to push now, they are not gonna have Black Hole.
Yes.
The siege might begin here. Black's going to start chipping away. They have some heroes backing him up right now, but you could tell with the Black Hole down, they're a bit nervous to go in.
And Isosize going to move towards the bottom lane. I guess the tier 2 at bottom will be their next objective here. It's the tower which has the lowest HP at the moment. The middle one has more or less full hit points, so the bottom tier 2 gonna be an easier target, and it will also give them time for the cooldown to come off Black Hole.
Some really nice
Black
wards
Hole to come off cooldown again.
Do want to mention some really nice wards by Vici Gaming here after that fight. They got two up near the mid lane, and Secret, normally the team that's taking over the enemy jungle, farming all three lanes and
gem
pushing.
On the X as well.
This was big, and it's not easy to get the gem away from him. There's only like the hookshot to cancel TP. Oh, they're jumping in mid momentarily. Where's Super's blink gonna come from? It's Arteezy who blinks back. He blinks back to safety, right? A Super blinks after him. Slightly missed time. Oh, they almost caught him out though. Now Black going to work, laying in with the Mask of Madness, but Test of Faith hits him. Oh my goodness, he drops Fez. Now he BKBs. He's clobbered down by a Satyr as he retreats. Black, oh, slow on the BKB. And now the fight may fall apart. Remember, he bought back early. I believe that's a full dieback for him. Chop not being used yet. Super just waiting. He gets it off. Now he's pushed all around. He calls and tries to run. Oh, he loses the gem. He loses a wicked six streak. It all began with Black. Slow on the BKB. Caught out of position. And now it gets worse and worse. Ice trying to salvage this with the split push, but Arteezy is hunting him. He blinks and he will TP out. Oh, Shadow Fiend gonna find him. They had the high ground ward to give Vision, and with that Ice in a whole lot of trouble. Malifus here. Fissure comes out, back up his Indol. They actually get the Arteezy kill. He gets a bit overconfident. Will they trade though? Now into the tree line. There is no black hole. They get the urn on Ice, but not before he blinks out. FY Shocking. Will be the one who pays, and he is brought down in the end. Did FY? Oh, not done yet. We've got Ursus chasing Ice. Oh my. They do lose their Shadow Fiend, but losing the gem and he's dying back on the sniper. Wow. Very
he's
costly.
Gonna survive. He's going to survive with the haste there.
A fortuitous haste. But when it's all said and done, that fight's still a big win for Secret. The gem, the big prize, and a dieback on the sniper, I believe, as well. From the maybe not a dieback officially, but he bought back earlier. Now he's dying again. The first 10-second BKB not doing much. Costly.
Yeah, it's very, very costly. He didn't do anything at all in the fight. And 10-second BKB judge down the drain.
If he BKBs earlier there, then it's he probably gets the kill on the clockwork.
I don't think he was in a good position as well. He was near the Chen creeps with his Mask of Madness turned on as well. He was taking damage from the creeps, and obviously the big damage that came from the Test of Faith of the Chen.
And he had they have the kind of lineup where he should be able to sit back, right? They have the Axe, mm-hmm. they have the Eidolons to do a bit of scouting and block incoming hooks, and they of course have the Earthshaker to protect, to bodyguard him, but...
They have 3 Force Staffs to protect him as well.
That's true, and in upcoming fights, it's important that he finds a way to stay back and not get caught.
Yeah, he needs to be very careful with his position.
But what's going to make it harder is that gem. They'll be dewarded more and more as this game moves along. And it's not like they have the easiest lineup to steal it away from a Queen of Pain at this point. So if S4 hangs onto it, then Vici Gaming, they lose their wards. That means the Clockwork Hooks are harder to predict. And he's got BKB now on S4, so maybe with a Blink Call, a Black Hole, they can kill him, but... It won't be easy.
Yeah, they can definitely kill him with all the spells at their disposal with the AI.
Oh, and they might even just go on him now. He swarmed his way into the tree line. Ice in position.
Clock is behind.
Clock is backing him up, though. Ice. He has the BKB. He goes in. S4 quick to use his own. Now silencing Ice. Still holding his own BKB. He's trying to bait. They want the call to come through. The black hole's here as well. Hookshot. Is it coming in? They're going to lose the jump, perhaps. He barely blinks out of the nick of time. Will he shatter? He's low, but no longer taking damage. No. Now they've stolen Black Hole. Oh, no. Back off, VG Gaming. This is not your fight to take. Requiem gonna just destroy Ice. And now they chase onward. They wanted the gem. They committed everything for it. Super. Next on the list, Kuroki whiffs the Black Hole, but the damage is still done. Black Hole on cooldown. 2 more deaths on Concours, and it's time for Secret to start taking objectives.
Oh my god, that was such a risky play there by them. They stacked the Berserker's Call and the Black Hole together though. If they didn't stack that, I think they got the kill on the Queen of Pain for sure. But too bad, they stacked their spells and here comes Arteezy. Gonna force the sniper to pop his BKB here.
The BKBs, they turn to fight, but the Queen of Pain all going right through that, just slaughtering Black. He's almost lost all his health already. That leaves his team on the back foot. FY connecting on a nice Echo Slam. There weren't too many creeps here, and as a result, they just fight their way through it. Now Black next on the list. He'll die as well. Vici Gaming falling apart. And it seems the 15-0 dream might well be alive. Not over yet by any means, but Secret sees momentum off of this. A team wipe. Roshan not respawning, and good news for Vici Gaming. And if they use this next stage just wisely, Secret could take all the tier 2s and bottle Vici up. Sniper's still the leader in net worth, though. As bad as it's looked recently.
You need to be more ahead, though, as a sniper. Sniper being even on net worth is just not the same as having a Shadow Fiend at that net worth. And they are just lucky the Roshan is not respawning yet. Otherwise, it could mean that it's just going to be very hard for them to take the upcoming fight with the Aegis on Arteezy. Next thing they need to secure for the game is like VG needs to at least get back to Aegis. Otherwise it's gonna be a very difficult uphill struggle.
It's very fortunate for Vici. If that's the 8-minute Roche, Secret have Aegis as well.
Yeah,
so they get lucky with the RNG.
That's one of those things where it could change the face of the game entirely.
Yeah, it's the issue for Vici though is they're not really the best Roshan lineup. Still no medallion, I believe, no minus armor of any kind. The physical damage they have is mediocre. It's not bad, but it's just not amazing either.
But they are very strong when they are fighting together as a team. a lot of big ultimate spells, big controls with the Black Hole and the Earthshaker and the Axe.
Well, this is not going to be given away freely, it looks like. Rockets coming out, moving towards the pit will be the Chen. The Rubik about to join him, and coming from the south is Quita Pei, and they TP in the clockwork towards mid with an Aghanim's picked up. This is a slow Roche. They're going to send in a Granite Golem to give warning to Vici that this Roche is not a freebie. And it's mid where Arteezy is posting up. Vici going for this now would be an extremely big gamble.
Yeah, Clockwork as well, being able to scout all the time. Here comes the smoke for me.
The hook, the hook. Zai's gonna start off, he connects on super. They quickly yules the Shadow, or rather the Enigma, just trying to ignore him, but they call Arteezy. He's being focused from the high ground by the sniper. He tries to run now, Quita Pei trying to bring that sniper down. The ulti does good damage. Zai laying into him just with auto attacks and Quita Pei support. They lose the sniper in exchange for the Shadow Feet, super scattering backwards. They never had a good Black Hole opening, so it's a 2-for-1. It's just... they're just able to jump this sniper, even when the hookshot's not onto him. Quita Pei jumps in, he BKBs, doesn't matter. The ulti still hits him. And but with just one Quita Pei ult, Winter, he's down below half health and forced to run.
Yeah, Mask of Madness, not very good there when you're taking damage. But
it's kind of, it's the old Quita Pei. I mean, this BKB would be amazing versus Secret, but... it's something we didn't really talk about too much before now. They're gonna contest though. This Roche is low. Super gets into the pit and tries to engage, but he's quickly dealt with and brought down. Now Ice also trapped in the pit. He may fall as well. The Radiant get the Roche. The Radiant get the Aegis. And four heroes again dead. The bodies hitting the floor all over the place. S4 barely surviving, even blinking up and forwards to start farming out the waves.
It was just rather unfortunate though for the Axe. He had BKB on cooldown for another few seconds, but they don't have a choice. They needed to make a move there, otherwise Roche was already going to be over, and Secret secures a huge advantage. But with that field still Roche at hand, Secret in a much better position. They know how much it means.
You can just see them like seizing control of the game. They realize just we had the one good fight, now we can prevent the Roche, we can contest Avicii, go for it. They take the Roche, we'll take the tier 2s now, we're going to drop some aggressive wards. You give Secret just an inch and they take a mile.
Oh, this sniper just feels like he's not going to be doing so much damage in the fights. He's going to be building an MKB right now. But I'm not so sure though. Probably anticipating Shadow Fiend going to have a butterfly or some sort, but he's not going to get anything along those lines.
I do feel Vici are much stronger on the high ground though. That's where you tend to clump. Ice Blast is more likely to hit multiple heroes. You have to worry about Echo Slam.
They don't have to push Blink. The 5 now.
Yeah, it's true.
Queen of Pain one lane, Shadow Fiend one lane, even the Chen creeps can be in one lane.
And that is generally how Secret like to play when they have this kind of lead. They don't normally push very early. They look to accrue a 20, 30k gold advantage, have all the lanes pushed in, as Arteezy will make his move top. He's going to set up on Fenrir, looking for the double raise here. Gets the first, the auto attack. Can't get the second, the hookshot off the mark by Zai. And it will allow Fenrir to retreat. But with the AA this low, he's going to have to walk back to base, and it seems Secret are going to get position on this tower. Hookshot is cooling down quite soon. In fact, it's already up. Kuroki now. Blinky forward. He's stolen Fissure.
Oh,
so much initiation now.
My thanks.
Oh dear. This is going to be very big. Usually you always, like, FY being a Rubik player himself, should always have the enchant after the Fissure. After all, he's human. He forgets sometimes.
Yeah, I don't... did he have time there? Because he Fissured, then blinked back immediately, and then Rubik immediately blinked forward and stole it. Maybe he could have enchanted right away.
He could have enchanted before you blink, but I guess he didn't expect it. That's why he didn't do that.
Yeah. It just shows you that Secret feel confident. That's not a play Rubik goes for if it's an even game, but when they have the lead like this, he can take those risks.
I mean, it's a worthy risk as well. It's such a big spell to have. It changes the course of the fights, and it's just like you stealing, like, it's just as good as stealing a Black Hole, I feel. Getting the Fissure on your side.
So we'll see a slightly unusual item here from S4, and I want to hear your thoughts on it. He goes for the Assault Caress and Queen of Pain. What do you think of this?
Armor against the Axe and the Sniper, right clicks. Why not?
Helps you push a lot too. With the Granite Golems, they now are very strong as a Death Ball.
Yeah, very strong.
They have more HP, they have minus armor and plus armor working their way. It's a good high ground siege lineup, and the one thing they're lacking that they're about to get is that Shadow Fiend Butterfly Sniper will have MKB soon, so I don't know how much it matters. Fenrir gonna get caught out by a hookshot, and he's trapped in by the cons. Nothing he can really do. They can't leave the base very easily. They're just not that kind of lineup. BKB now forced out as Super. Tries to run, the golem slowing him down. And of God deployed. But everyone's back in the base. They'll blink forward with FY. They don't really want to go on S4 right now, and he's much happier to engage. Assassinate trying to drive him back, but the hookshot in again by Zai. On to Black. Black Hole's there. Catches out to Zai as well as Arteezy, but where's the follow-up damage? It's lacking, and now it's stolen by Kuroki. Again, he delivers with the gigantic spell steals. 3, make it 4 dead. Black on the run after the buyback. Might die a second time if he's not careful. He'll bring down S4. That's only the Aegis down. FY engages, gets off the Echo Slam. It's a really good-looking one, but it doesn't matter. It's not good-looking. Looking enough, FY will fall again. That's death number 5 with the sniper buyback, and with that, it might well be GG. Secret, they could smell it, they could taste it. 15-0, it's within their grasp now, and there's just not much. Vici, they give up, they call the GG. Kuroki celebrates with a stolen Echo Slam of all things. Secret Winter, they look very fierce heading into the playoffs.
They lost this game just because of one thing. The biggest turning point was the Black when
the fight mid
when they had a lead. He went in and he was in an awkward position and his team was already backing. This was something that I was talking to you about, like during the breaks, that I felt that sometimes Black isn't on sync with his team because he obviously doesn't.